Hey, so my name's Jess. I'm a mechanical engineering student, master student at ETH Zurich, and today I'm going to be filming a day in the life of a mechanical engineer. Because looks like a lot of people are hungry to see it, and also today I get to do experiments. So usually I do a lot of simulations, which you will see later, but today I get to do experiments to back up my simulations, which you will also see later if I get permission from my prof. Also, if you're wondering, no, didn't go to the gym this morning because I was too tired. Hashtag engineering life, lol. Okay, maybe I'll explain my simulations a little bit. So I am like simulating a gas turbine, or like a burner within a gas turbine, and it has two flames in it. So I already simulated the burner like in using computational fluid dynamics, CFD, or large eddy simulation, LES. So now what I'm doing is I'm gonna be doing the experiments to sort of verify my simulations. Does that make sense? You'll see. So now we are approaching ETH. That's the main building. That's my building. Main building is much more beautiful. So here, this is a giant engine we have. You can see it's pretty dope, pretty big. And so this is pretty much what I do. General Electric, Swiss Air. Cool, huh? Hand for scale. Okay, so I'm in my office and I'm gonna show you some of my simulation. So, there we go. So this is the first flame. Yeah, this is like the temperature of the flame. So the red part is the hot part. Here we have the oxygen, and then here we have the fuel. So obviously when the fuel burns, there's no more fuel inside the flame. So that's why it's white on the inside. Same with the oxygen, it's blue on the inside because there's no oxygen once it burns, because we're burning fueling. And so this is my first flame, and now I'll show you my second flame. So now you can see my two flames. So this is the flame I just showed you. It's kind of going crazy here. Here I have extra air coming in, and here I have extra fuel coming in. And because the flow is so hot, there is this second flame that's forming. So you can see it's kind of like a dragon. And so it's pumping, and this is an instability. So do you see that? Yeah, so if you have, I guess, any more questions about this, you can just, like, comment below. Yeah, pretty much that's my project, and I think it's pretty cool. I think if we can duplicate it in experiments, it would be way cooler, so I'm gonna ask my supervisor if I can do that. Yes, so stay tuned. So, this is my friend, Luigi, from Italy. Luigi, where are you from? What is your name?
It's Luigi, and uh-huh. Toldi. Told them, and yeah, I'm from Italy. And then
from Italy.
I didn't do that. Please. Could you please stop the video, or I have to go through my whole life? Like,
so this is your mechanical engineering project.
Yeah. And there are also very similar.
A gray screen.
Exactly.
So here I'm inside the control room of our burner. I should be looking at the camera. And here's my supervisor checking on the test rig. I didn't want to use my own footage because I didn't want to get in trouble, so this is the footage from my lab's website. Pretty much, I don't know what you want me to tell you. I just finished the experiments, now I'm extracting data, gonna put into a presentation. Pretty fun, life of an engineering student. So this is the Messung von der Verweilzeitspektren. Yeah, clearly, you know exactly what that means. What is this thing called? A scrubber? When you try to like separate NOx or
CO2 from air or from exhaust gas. So pretty much, I'm pretty sure, like, the exhaust goes from the bottom up here. This material is some sort of absorbent material that absorbs the NOx or the exhaust. And the clean gas exits, or something like that. Actually, I decided this is a good thing to explain. So, yeah, pretty much this is exactly what we're doing. Here we have our first stage burner, and this is the test rig. And here we have the second flame. And so these two flames interact together, and they create like acoustic modes. And so this is the test rig that I am simulating right now. So I'm simulating it here. You can see that this is a flame. So this is exactly what I'm simulating that I showed earlier. Or this is another way to visualize the exact same simulation. Yeah, you can use high-speed laser diagnostics to view it in the experiment. So this is a simulation, and this is what you use to see the experiment. So you pretty much seed the flow with some sort of fluorescent material. Then you use a laser to make it fluoresce, so make the light, make like the whatever you seeded it with fluoresce in a different color. And then you use high-speed camera to record. And so the application is for like these different gas turbine engines. So you can see here, you have the first flame and the second flame. So that's pretty much the application of this burner. Yeah, there we go again. One flame, second flame. Well, there's three and two, but you know what I mean. And this is the motivation behind it. Pretty much, we're burning oil, gas, and coal, and we're always gonna keep burning them till we run out. So, and on top of that, wind and solar are very sporadic, but this is the demand. So this is constant, but renewables are not constant. So we have to figure out a way, which is gas turbines and burning gas, oil, and coal. And we have to use these pretty much to make up for this demand when we don't have renewables available. So that's the point of, that's why we use gas turbines still. And so what we're trying to do is just make this more efficient. So one way to make it more efficient is to use two flames. But in order to do that, we have to investigate the two flames in the burner, which is what I'm doing. And that's it.
Yeah, pretty much. That's my life as a mechanical engineering student at ETH Zurich. That evening, I didn't really do much. I came home, I ate a salad, and then I watched Parks and Recreation. Let me know below if you're a mechanical engineer and if your student life is different. Chances are that if you're in your bachelor's, it's way more packed than mine. Yeah, and also like and subscribe. Also, I just recently made friends with Everything K, and she is in computer science, I believe, at Waterloo, which is not too far from where I live in Canada. And she has like a lifestyle YouTube, but she kind of wants to transition into a computer science-y YouTube channel. So if that interests you at all, then go over there and show your support. I have her listed down as one of my featured channels.